Dear friends, welcome to the next discussion on the topic of media writing. In the earlier lecture, we have talked about the purpose of media writing, the kinds of media writing, factors of writing, approach of writing, and the components of language. In this discussion, we shall move on to discuss the specific requirements of writing for the print media. The print media, as you know, is the medium which uses newsprint or paper as the platform for carrying the message onward to a wide range of audience who can at least read. Now, what are the kinds of writing required for print media? Broadly, these are as follows: news report, news analysis, feature, interview, backgrounder, curtain raiser, review, and editorial. I am sure you have heard some of these names before, but some of the names you must be hearing for the first time. Before moving on to specific items, let us know what are the common points that are common to all kinds of writing in the print. The common points can be classified as: 1. All such writing has a long retention value and kept as record and can also be cited as evidence. Anything that appears in print in newspaper or a magazine can obviously be kept in shelves, in almirahs, in libraries for a long time, and if the need arises, they can be cited as either reference or even evidence in a court of law. 2. All information, regardless of its form and source, has to be conveyed through the use of phrases and expressions of language, because here you have only one medium to express, and that is the written word. 3. The sights, sounds, and background of all information related to any event, person, or place have to be conveyed with the most appropriate words. Next, facts, opinion, questions, emotions, and sentiments, everything has to be expressed through words and the right phrases. And next, the quality of writing has to be such that leaves an impact on the reader and it is remembered long enough to influence opinion making. The components of media writing in print are the same as had been mentioned in the earlier discussion, that is, a segment of introduction, a segment of description, and the last segment of conclusion. Now, let us move on to specific kinds of media writing for print media. The first kind of writing is writing news or writing a news report. This is the first, the most visible, and the most significant form of writing for the print media. Now, before going into news writing, let's talk about what is news, what comprises news. The most acceptable definition of news is that news is any information that is timely, that is interesting, and that is significant for the people in general, in respect to their personal affairs or their relationship with society. The best news is that which possesses the greatest degree of this interest and significance for the greatest number of people. In short, news comprises all such information that needs to be known in the widest public interest. Therefore, almost everyone, regardless of differences in age, socio-political background, class, location, time, and professional or personal backgrounds, is interested in news. A society comprises people who are highly educated as well as average literate or even completely illiterate. But for all of them, the value and importance of news is similar, even though its interpretation and impact could be different for people who are highly educated and could be different for people who are barely literate. Therefore, news has to be written in such a manner that it makes sense to a writer, a politician, a common man, a businessman, an employee, a shopkeeper, an officer, as also a poor, illiterate street laborer. Obviously, for an illiterate person, the news will be read out to him aloud by someone else because he is illiterate. It means that the meaning of news should remain intact in all cases, whether the reader reads it himself or it is read out by someone else to someone else. That brings us to the ingredients of news writing. As mentioned earlier, all news must answer the questions of 5 W's and 1 H. This is the basis on which news writing can even begin. Other points to remember for print news writing is: 1. News writing must convey meaning to an extremely diverse audience, from the highest literacy to barely literate. The meaning should be clear and the same at all these levels. The words and sentences must be chosen in such a way that it suits the needs of a casual reader as well as a critical reader. Use of complicated words, expressions, technical jargon, rarely used phrases, and excessive historical references must be avoided. All information should be cross-checked and correct to the greatest extent possible, because whatever appears in print is considered as record for official purposes and also sometimes for legal purposes. The most important characteristics of news writing are as follows. Number 1, the inverted pyramid style. This is the most accepted structure of most straight news items. It focuses the more important parts of the report at the beginning, thus helping the reader distinguish the more significant details from the less significant details. The rationale behind this is that the readers have a limited time to spend on reading newspapers. The readers who want fewer details can leave reading the report at any point they wish, with the assurance that no more significant details are buried further down. That means, if they have read the earlier few sentences and they do not wish to read further, they should miss out nothing. To make sure that this style is followed, it is important that answers to all the 5 W's and 1 H are included in the first part of the news report itself, and this is known as the introduction. The second part is the impersonal tone of news writing. An impersonal tone is important to ensure that the news is separated from opinion. It is a precondition of news writing that may conflict with principles of readability. If it is impersonal, it might not be very readable, but it should be impersonal so that everybody can read it. This kind of a style is followed so that the news reporters or the news writers' own personal views are not reflected in the news report. The intention is to present things as they happened and not add personal comment, which may make the report less acceptable to some readers. The next point is giving references and credit. Since the purpose of writing a news report is to give the facts without any comments, it is important to be correct in case of facts such as figures, dates, and other statistics. To make sure that the reader also gets the right picture, all facts must be attributed to the source or references be given. This ensures that the responsibility for the correctness of facts is placed by the reporter to the right source. Now, let us see an example of news writing with these points. The headline says, announcement of an increase in the price of petroleum products. And the item reads as follows: New Delhi, January 1. The central government today announced an increase in all petroleum product prices by 10% over the existing prices. The increase will come into effect tonight all over the country. The increase will lead to the generation of rupees 500 crores in this financial year and help in cutting down on revenue deficit. Now, this is an introduction. Now let's analyze it quickly. This text answers the five basic questions. What? The first W is what? The price of petroleum products has been increased. Next is when? On the day of the announcement. Next is where? It is announced either in parliament or at a press conference. Who? The government made a decision. Why? For more revenue generation. And lastly, how? The 1H. By an order applicable all over the country. Now we see that the introduction gives the necessary details, and anyone who does not read further will not miss out on anything important. The description part after the introduction will carry information about the name of the person who announced it, Mr. So and so, a secretary announced it. And where was the announcement made? It was made in the Press Information Bureau or in Lok Sabha, wherever. The time of the day, this afternoon or this evening. And who was present at the time of the announcement? When the announcement was being made, the minister and other people were also present. Now, all these are details which may not be necessary for the basic news to be known to every reader. The conclusion part, that is the part 3 of the news, will carry information about figures of revenue deficit. The price increase has led to a revenue generation of a certain amount. So, what was the deficit? The earning from this movement, this measure, how many times the prices had been increased in the last 1 year, and the quick reactions. Now, we can understand that how other news reports should be written for issues such as election result, proceedings of the state assembly, visit of a foreign dignitary, a major accident, escape of prisoners from a jail, a seminar on water conservation, or the killing of a tiger by illegal hunters. In every kind of news, as I have mentioned here, the introduction should answer the questions of 5 W's and 1 H, so that the average reader gets the answers quickly, and the further description and the conclusion can even be skipped by them without missing out on the basic details. This is the hallmark of a news report. The next category of writing is writing a news analysis. A news analysis is a detailed description of a news event, its implications and circumstances that led to it, along with an analysis of the main event and those related to it. The requirements of a news analysis make it imperative that it is written by an expert or someone who has a long experience in the subject. Such media writing can only be used on specific occasions and places, not on every page, not on top of the page, not on bottom of the page, but news analysis has a place designated for it, either on the editorial page or on the views page. The basic components of a news analysis are the basic facts, the chronology of events in order they happened, comments of experts, future implications of the subject which is being analyzed, similar examples in other states or in other countries, personal opinion of the reader who is supposed to be an expert, and possible inferences, the impact as to what will happen now. Those who are beginners in the media writing are advised to avoid writing news analysis in the beginning of their career. Such writing should be attempted only after spending some time in the chosen field, acquiring expertise, and getting a proper perspective of the subject. The language required for writing news analysis should be mature and appropriate for putting forward an opinion and supporting it. It must include quotations from previously published works such as books, research papers, and other texts to support the opinion which is now being put forward. It also must reflect a deep knowledge of the subject. The next kind of writing is a feature. A feature is often considered to be the easiest kind of media writing, and most beginners find it very easy to handle. Basically, a feature is a detailed description of any place, people, or event. picking up from a set of facts and then building up with lots of color, adjective, description, quotes, and references. Examples are features written typically on the weather conditions, on festivals, fairs, tourist spots, celebrity people, gadgets, commemorative days, and so on. As we can see, such writing is largely based on facts which are already available and other material which is also already available. And the key to originality in the writing lies in presentation and quotes. For a beginner in media studies, it is most convenient to collect some material on a festival such as Diwali or Christmas, make a visit to the market and stores on a couple of occasions, and then compile everything to present a feature on the festival. It should of course be correct with facts, names, figures, etc., and there is a possibility that two features on the same subject may be quite alike. While writing a feature, it is important that the subject is described properly, there is a flow in narration, and the style is kept racy and entertaining. A feature is generally used on special pages such as weekend supplements, Sunday magazine, special interest pages such as careers, education, women, entertainment, travel, and so on. Incidentally, a feature can be very easily prepared by a non-media person also, since the material would be readily available to them also on the internet, in the library, and so on. And they can put in some personal anecdotes to make it interesting. I am mentioning this because in many publications, feature writing is assigned to non-journalists also, because they feel that it brings in a lot of different color in the form of writing in that publication. The next kind of writing is writing an interview. Interview is one of the most popular and sought after kinds of writing, both by newcomers and seniors in the world of media. An interview is a one-to-one conversation between a reporter, writer, and a person who is in the news or is important because of any current reason. It provides an opportunity to the interviewer to establish close and sometimes personal contact with the person concerned. An interview could be conducted on occasions such as commemorative days, significant announcements, anniversaries, visits by dignitaries, honors and awards, forgotten heroes, and so on. In fact, an interesting interview can be conducted on any day, anywhere, with anyone, provided there is a relevance to it. As we can see, it is not possible for a journalist to actually write an interview because the main text for the interview comes from the guest who is being interviewed. The journalist only frames the questions and puts them to the guest. Therefore, the requirements for writing an interview are basically related to framing the questions and then putting the answers in the right place, right order, and the right perspective. An interview can be written in two forms. First is the question-answer form, in which the questions put forth by the interviewer and the answers given by the guest are written down as they come, and actual words and expressions are reproduced in this form. It is important to take detailed notes in this form to maintain and ensure authenticity of expression. It is written in the same order in which the questions are asked. The second form of writing an interview is the feature form. In this form, the gist of the questions and the answers are written as text in text form, and they are not broken into Q and A, that is the question and answer format. It is also possible in this form not to maintain the same order of questions and answers, but the more important answer or the point can be written first, followed by the less important ones. However, a conversation style of writing is maintained throughout this feature as well as in the previous feature. Essentially, after an interview is conducted, the material needs to be written down in three segments. First is introduction or a brief background of the guest who is being interviewed, including the purpose and occasion why the interview is being conducted. The second is the main text, either in question and answer segment form or the main text form, that incorporates the important points of both questions and answers. And the third is the conclusion, which is basically a wrap-up of the conversation with possibly a personal observation, such as the interview concluded, Mr. Narayan said goodbye and moved back to his library to pick up on his writing where he had left, and the interview ends. Or another example could be, Madhuri answered the last question in a rush as the call came from her director to report for shooting the next scene. Now, the interview in both these cases could be written either in the Q&A form or in the text form, but while ending it, this kind of a twist can be given to make it more readable and more interesting. Some points to be remembered while writing an interview are to include some personal references about the appearance or the color of the dress that the guest is wearing. All of you must have noticed that in case of any interview, the interviewer, the reporter, always mentions that the person being interviewed was wearing a blue dress or a white dress, or to make a brief mention of the place or surroundings where the interview is being conducted. The interview took place over a cup of tea. The interview took place while walking in the garden, and so on. And to make comparisons if the same person is being interviewed after a gap of some time. These three are the basic points which should be mentioned in the interview to keep it from getting very boring or repetitive, because it establishes a personal contact between the interview writer and the reader of that print. Interviews, incidentally, have a very high readability rate. Therefore, the writer must make every effort to make them interesting, readable, and memorable, either with the choice of questions or with the style of writing. Interviews can lead to forming a long-lasting relationship, or if they are not conducted properly, they can destroy a good relationship. Now we move on to backgrounder. As the name suggests, a backgrounder is a form of writing where the background information or a description of events leading up to the latest event is given. Usually, a backgrounder is used along with the main item of an important happening. For example, a backgrounder will be used when some individual assumes an important office or when an important decision is announced by the government. The backgrounder is generally used separately, either alongside the main item or on a different space. The backgrounder is generally a straight piece of writing, either in the form of chronology, that is, mentioning facts in the order of time they happened, or in the form of text. Comments or personal opinion is avoided in a backgrounder, since the purpose of giving a backgrounder is to provide proper perspective by filling up gaps in information. The mention of facts and figures, distances, dates, names of places and people is a must in a backgrounder. Since the source of a backgrounder is generally a yearbook, a reference book, the internet, or any other agency, the language of a backgrounder could be common to many publications. A writer, therefore, may not have to do much effort in putting together a backgrounder. Incidentally, in the case of the demise or death of a prominent person, an obituary or a life sketch is used along with the main news. This is also in the nature of a backgrounder on that person, and such items are often written by persons who may not be journalists, but they have been fellow professionals, such as a politician or an actor or a drama writer or a writer or an actor, and so on. So a backgrounder can be written by persons who are not media persons, but in such cases the language of the backgrounder could be a little personal or even evoke nostalgia to keep it different from other publications. For beginners, Writing a backgrounder is a good exercise in learning straight writing, putting facts and figures in right chronological order, and also learn what needs to be included and what should be kept out, depending on the importance of the occasion of the backgrounder. Curtain raiser. A curtain raiser is a kind of writing that is used before an important event, giving the build-up to the event, such as installation of a new government, a sports match, opening of an exhibition, conference, or any other much-awaited happening. It is different from a backgrounder in the sense that a backgrounder contains what has already happened, whereas a curtain raiser gives the build-up of what is going to happen. A curtain raiser simply raises the curtain to a much anticipated event. It gives details of the event, such as timing, sequence of events as they are likely to happen. It may also contain a timeline of what has happened to connect it to what is going to happen. Generally, a curtain raiser is not very long or descriptive. The purpose of a curtain raiser is simply to inform the readers as to what is going to happen, which is different from a backgrounder. For beginners, it is also an easy kind of writing to do, because any special analytical or opinion-making expressions are not required. There is little scope for showing off language skills in a curtain raiser. For example, the curtain raiser to a university examination would read something like this: nearly 10,000 students of the special university will take part in the annual examinations that begin tomorrow. The examinations are spread over 2 months. A team of 200 invigilators will be supervising the exercise that has been delayed by 1 month from the scheduled date. Now, the source of such a curtain raiser, the source of facts in such a curtain raiser, much like the backgrounder, could be common to many publications, such as coming from a reference book. Therefore, it is very common to find similar reading curtain raisers in many publications. Now we come to a review. A review is a kind of writing that provides a comprehensive picture of a fine arts performance, such as dance, drama, stage show, a film, and also a book. This kind of writing is generally entrusted to either a specialized writer or a subject specialist, who may not necessarily be a writer also. But there are certain journalists who take up review writing as part of their professional skill. Even if they are editors, copy editors, or reporters, they can be movie reviewers or book reviewers and so on. Now, writing a review requires knowledge of the subject matter of the performance of the or the product, such as the book. And therefore, the writer must pay serious attention in viewing, listening to, or reading the subject under review. For beginners, it is a good exercise to go through a stage performance, or see a film, or read a book, and then write a review. Such a review exercise should then be compared with what appears in regular publications to understand what is lacking. A review must also contain the following details: the technical details, such as the duration of a performance, the number of pages, and the prices in the case of a book; credits, such as the name of the producer, director, writer, cast, publishers, price and page in the case of a book; comparisons to discuss the relative merit of a work, such as comparisons could be drawn to a similar work by others or an earlier work by the same person; and quotes. A review must always contain quotes in case of a book, or bits of dialogues or scenes description or exact description of a performance. A review, incidentally, is a very interesting kind of writing for beginners, and they should be encouraged to do it. It gives you an opportunity to improve your observation skills, use favorite expressions and adjectives, and even professional journalists love to write reviews of their favorite film, favorite book, or favorite performance, even though they might not get the time to do it. But every journalist loves to write in a review. Now we come to the editorial. An editorial is the most serious and important piece of writing in a journalistic publication, whether it is a newspaper or a magazine. It is the voice of the publication itself and reflects the opinion of the people and readers, even though it is written by the editor. It is to indicate its importance that the editorial appears at a fixed place in every publication, in every issue. For example, you must have noticed that in daily newspapers, the editorial always appears in the same corner of the same page every day. An editorial represents the collective response of the media, especially when it comes to a policy decision or a government measure. It is supposed to convey what the people think, and therefore it is always taken seriously by the readers, the establishment, and obviously by the editor himself. An editorial is written by that editor who is responsible for bringing out the publication, that is the newspaper or the magazine. Therefore, this responsibility is entrusted to the chief editor himself or to an editor who is considered fit for this work. Journalists who begin as reporters or sub-editors do not get the opportunity to write editorial for years. It is only after they become mature enough in their opinion, their understanding of the affairs of the society and the government, and realize what impact their writing could have upon the people, that they are given this responsibility. An editorial is basically a combination of news analysis, review, and opinion, all put together to reflect and also guide public opinion. Written with feeling and passion, it can lead to an uprising, a revolution, or worse, a riot or a conflict. Editorials carry special significance in times such as an election, a war, or other disturbed times, as also on occasions that affect public interest, such as a budget, a government formation, or a decision by the government, and so on. An editorial comprises a brief introduction to the topic that is being taken up, with a precise mention of the fact that is the focus of the comment. For example, if an editorial is written on the budget, then it could be a measure such as the reduction in income tax rates that will be the focus of the editorial rather than the whole budget. In such a case, the complete facts of the reduction offered in the budget should be mentioned so that the readers get to know not only about the fact but its implications also. It must be remembered that there is no room for any mistake or oversight in the facts, figures, and quotes mentioned in the editorial. Any mistake in the editorial is like failure of the media itself in discharging its duties. It is like a mistake in a judgment passed by the court or a law made by Parliament. Simple language that is understandable by the spectrum of readers, unlike an essay, combined with a clear and unambiguous comment, are the hallmarks of an editorial. Beginners must try to write editorials on issues of wide public interest. Attempts must be made to express an opinion that is personal, but at the same time reflect the opinion of the largest sections of the society. It must be remembered that an editorial opinion could influence everyone in the society, even if everyone is not a reader of that editorial. Now we move on to other kinds of writing. A print media journalist is required to do other small bits of writing also as part of his job. These are in the nature of indicators, navigations, reminders, and design accessories. Some of these are as follows. An intro. An intro is a brief roundup of an article that is generally given in the beginning, containing the name of the writer also. A blurb. A blurb is a small part of the main text confined to one or two sentences that is used in a box in the middle of the text, generally to break the monotony of the display. A pointer. A pointer is an indication to a related or extended part of an item, either used on the same page or on different pages. caption. A caption is the brief description of the contents of a photograph used in one or two lines just below a photograph, generally containing the name of the photographer or the source of the photograph. Headline. A headline is the most eye-catching and important part of any item in a publication. It is the window to the main text. If it is interesting, it attracts a reader to read the item. If it is not, it can put off a reader or give an undesirable impact. A summary. A summary is a brief roundup of any item, usually given separately on a different page. It is also used when a long item is used in two or more parts, with a summary of the earlier part being used in the subsequent part. Now, some other kinds of writing. With the rapid growth in the print media, a large number of special interest publications have also become very popular. Such publications carry items like travelogues, recipes, essays, surveys, opinion polls, and so on. These items are of a specialized nature and require some subject and technical skills also. For beginners, this brings us to an end of the kind of writing required in the print media. Now we will have a look at the writing for radio and television, that is broadcast media. Print media uses print space on paper, technically known as newsprint, as the platform for conveying information. The paper is used in newspapers, magazines, and other periodicals, and paper has a shelf life, meaning that it can be retained in our homes or offices or library for a reasonable period of time. And since paper is a physical entity, its use can be controlled or extended depending on the writer. The length of writing is measured in terms of centimeters, so to say. But in case of audio and visual media, that is radio and television, the platform used is voice, sound, and visuals. It cannot be held physically, but it can be heard and seen. Obviously, the measurement of its extent is in seconds and minutes, not in centimeters. While in print, the material is written and is read by whoever holds the paper publication in hand. In case of radio and television, the written material is broadcast to air and it can be heard and seen by whoever has the equipment to catch it. The equipment is a radio or a TV. And now it is small, easy to carry, and easily accessible. Significantly, a radio or TV broadcast can be heard by not only the person who has a radio or TV, but by many others who are in the range of hearing and viewing the broadcast. It is truly a medium of mass communication where masses can be addressed without the need for a medium that is physically handled, such as paper. Rather, the masses can be addressed with a specific medium, that is radio and television, and with one equipment, the message can be communicated to many others. The writing required for audiovisual media is for items similar to print, such as news report, news analysis, feature, and interview. But there are certain kinds of writing and items that are typical to radio and television, such as a discussion, a documentary, or live reporting. But first of all, before moving on to writing, let us understand the basics of broadcasting. What is meant by broadcast? Simply put, it means a combination of two words, broad and cast, that is to convey over a wide range of distance. It can be in two forms, that is audio, a sound, or visual in picture. While radio conveys only through sound, television conveys through sound and visuals. The impact and influence of radio reaches far and wide because it works on the sense of hearing through the ears. In case of television, the impact is still greater as it combines voice with visuals that catch immediate attention. As compared to print, the effect of radio or TV broadcast could be transitory because there is no shelf life. The radio and TV broadcast cannot be stored unless recorded with the help of technical equipment. Also, in radio and TV, the limiting factor is time, and it is not possible or easy to quote a broadcast as a reference, whereas in the case of print, a printed material can be quoted as a reference. In broadcasting, the requirements are a message, that is the content in the nature of news, views, interviews, solo talk, group discussion, feature and documentary. And number two, the presenter. The medium of radio and TV requires a presenter who can be a narrator, a speaker, an anchor, a moderator or a comparer. In the background, however, there is always a writer who prepares a script that is read aloud by either the writer himself or by a presenter who can be different from the writer. Then there is production. Broadcasting requires some technical specifications to be met. It means integrating voice, sound with visuals. The sound can be background sound, effects, quotes, narration or music. The visuals can be live, static or even created. The major advantages of broadcasting are that it brings quicker recall, recognition and response. There is an element of glamour and greater immediate impact. At the same time, there are certain disadvantages of broadcasting, that is, the imagery that is created with sound and visuals is short-lived and fades out of memory much quicker. There is a constant need for innovation, as listening to similar sounds on a repeated basis can lead to listener boredom. But most important of all, in broadcast, the quality of content or material is not always the sole criterion of success or impact. Very often, the treatment becomes more important than the content. That means, if a weak content is presented with special sound effect, a good voice and background, then it will have greater impact, greater listener attention as compared to a very well-written news article. It must be understood in the beginning that whatever is broadcast on radio and TV is first written on paper and goes through the same process of rewriting and corrections that is done in the case of print. In case of radio and TV, the written document that is read out is known as the script. This means that a script has to be written and prepared, whether it is broadcast of news, features, discussion and so on. Therefore, when we discuss writing for radio and TV, we mean writing a script that ultimately goes for broadcast, whoever speaks it out in front of the microphone. Now let us move on to different kinds of writing for radio and TV. A news report. News on radio and TV has always had a great and lasting impact on listeners and viewers. The voice of the newsreader plays a vital role, but the script is read out only by the newsreader. It is written by someone else. All news, as is the case of news anywhere, must answer the questions of 5 W's and 1 H. The seriousness and timeliness of the answers to each of the above decide the news value of an item, especially in case of radio and TV. For these two medium, there could be two kinds of news. One is hard news, that is timely, quick and in the nature of first information. The other is soft news, which has less influence and contains a lot of background information. Now, what makes news on TV is what should be written. The most common points for a checklist of news value for TV are: what is the issue, who are the people involved, why is the issue important, where it is located, how does it affect the life of others, and when did the issue emerge. Factors determining newsworthiness are proximity in terms of time and space. What is nearer home and most recently happened is bigger news. That is, small incident in the place of broadcast station itself in your own city is far more important than anything big happening in some other part of the world. Magnitude in the terms of size of a problem, that is, the greater the number of parties or people involved, the bigger is the news. The larger the conflict, the bigger is the news, because it has to be shown and talked about. consequences in the case of a news in terms of greater impact and relevance makes it bigger news, such as making of a dam that will displace an entire village. Because the visuals are striking, therefore it makes for big news. Human interest always makes news irrespective of the place, size or consequence, such as you must have seen on TV, even a poor child falling in a pit is always news because it touches a human chord. Humor in daily life always makes for good news on TV and print, such as serious and grim politicians making a joke in the parliament. Now, writing a news script for broadcast. In the presentation of news, the presenter and viewer come face to face. If it is a newsreader, he is talking to his listener. If he is a newsreader on TV, he is talking to the viewer. And therefore, the script should not be very formal or very informal. The keys to greater impact in a news script are the biggest points in a story, how to begin a story, the quality of voice, the placement of visuals and the sound bites. To make news script strongly effective, some points are use of familiar or simple words, short sentences and avoiding long-winded sentences, proper pause for dramatic effect, avoiding passive voice, avoiding unusual words or jargon or idioms, avoiding being very clever, having a correct pronunciation and showing one's involvement in the news. While writing, it should be remembered that the audience is diverse and unequally aware of the facts. That means some may know everything while some may know nothing. Therefore, the script has to aim for those who know nothing. Chances are that those who know everything will also listen to it. A radio or TV news report cannot and should not be written as a print report even if the facts are the same. For example, the headline of an item announcing election dates in print will say election in UP on April 7 and the rest will go in the main text, while TV will say election dates for UP have been announced and the rest will follow in voice with graphics and visuals. A news script must keep viewers' interest alive with sentences that seem like conversation and announcements depending upon the nature of information. Subdued informality is the key. Avoiding tongue twisters, hissing words, repetition, and wandering of the eyes on TV is very important. And while writing a script, scope should always be left for impromptu innovation, even if the script is complete, so that the news reader on radio and TV can put in something on his own part if the narrative becomes a little dull. Keeping proper speed of narration while introducing a quote, stepping up with information and stepping down with conclusion, and simplifying of information in case of a complication, and using of simple synonyms rather than complex words. Components of a script. Whatever you see on television or hear on radio is based on something that has been specifically written for that item, that broadcast. Like in print, not all kinds of writing is suitable for public consumption. And the intention is to make the writing acceptable to the largest section of the audience, that is the basic of mass communication. Similarly, whatever one shoots or records is not suitable for public broadcast or public viewing. It means that before starting to record or shoot, one has to have a suitable basis for the exercise, and therefore the script comes into the picture. The script obviously is the written document containing the dialogue and the actions, the text, and whatever innovations are to be put are mentioned in the script itself. In news, the script contains the words which are spoken by the presenter. In programs such as features, it is the text spoken by each player in that order. In entertainment such as countdown programs and other entertainment news, it includes the text spoken by the presenter plus highlights of the action or any other movement which is being shown in the background in case of TV. For programs related to entertainment, there is a lot of creative freedom, but in case of news, this freedom is not there. Writing for TV is completely different from writing for print because it uses time instead of space. In print, the report can be edited again and again in little time before it goes to print so that it can be adjusted finally on the paper. But in TV, it is not always possible because editing is a time-taking process and may adversely affect the overall quality of the program. A script is based on an idea or a concept. The idea can be just one word, such as ragging, something on ragging. Now, ragging is the concept or idea, and the reporter or the writer has to write a script for a feature or a news documentary on ragging. So, in such case, it has to be written down as you would like to show. It has to be written in the order in which you want your reviewers to see it. All this information, that is concept, then what is to be shown, what is to be read, is in totality means a script. It must include principal characters, the mention of visuals, sounds and suggestions, sequence of events and other technical details. It is very clear that while writing a script or while writing for TV and radio, a lot of research is required before starting work on any project or production. It is important to learn about the background, about the sights and sounds, pictures, historical facts, backgrounders, reaction and sounds also, because all this must find mention in the script so that it can be included while it is being broadcast. A sense of visualization. The idea, whatever is to be written down, should be visualized by the scriptwriter, whether it is for radio or for TV. The writer has to imagine how it will sound if it is broadcast on TV, on radio, and how it will appear if it is telecast on TV. So, a sense of visualization is important in writing both kinds of scripts, and obviously some kind of training on voice and speech is also important for the writer so that he writes only those words which can be pronounced properly. As in the case of print, through the use of words, certain emotions, visuals, sounds and everything has to be created. The use of certain imagery is important to make the full and complete picture presented to the viewer and reader. Now, writing a script for TV and radio has to take into account the technical aspects also. Therefore, the knowledge of procedures of sound recording, camera operation, background music, sound and visual creation, editing and other technical processes is also very important. A script does not get broadcast in isolation. Very often, a good written script does not make for a good program because adequate visual or sound support may not be available. Therefore, writing for radio and television requires additional knowledge of technical aspects. It can be written in the form of a single sentence idea, but the writer should know how it can be developed for speaking out or for showing out through shooting. In the end, let us sum up the points related to writing for print and electronic media that we discussed today. Print media generally requires items such as news reports, news analysis, feature, interview, backgrounder, curtain raiser, review and editorial. All these are of different nature and require different degrees of maturity, experience and exposure. There are certain common points in all kinds of print media writing, such as credibility of facts, appropriate expressions to convey the sights and sounds of any subject, using language that leaves an impact, influences opinion and can be cited as reference for all time, even becoming part of historical record. Largely, all kinds of media writing comprise an introduction, description, and conclusion. Broadcast media has its advantages and disadvantages, but it certainly reaches a far greater and bigger audience. It has greater impact because it combines voice with sound, visuals, and special effects. In broadcast media, the kind of items are similar to that in print, such as news, analysis, feature, interview, etc. But there are certain specific items that are not relevant for print, such as discussions, documentaries, and live broadcast. Writing for broadcast media also requires a greater presence of mind, because here the measurement is in terms of seconds and minutes rather than centimeters. Writing for radio and TV requires knowledge of technical aspects also, such as recording, camera effects, and so on. This is all for today. Thank you, best wishes, and have a good day.
How to write a news story. Hey, do you want to write a news story? It could be for a school newspaper, a yearbook, or to appease an evil teacher that will squeeze your guts out if you don't cater to his or her every whim. Whatever the reason, here are a few tips to get you started. Step 1. Pick your topic. When writing a good story, remember to pick a topic that nobody really cares about. You could get the scoop on that idiot kid who got stuck in a porta potty, or maybe find out about that new phone book being released. Here's a great rule of thumb. If it sounds exciting, stay away. Remember to always have a great title that relates to your topic, like Porta Problems or Who the Hell is Going to Read This Crap? Step 2. Write a lead-in. Since only a small percentage of students are actually willing to read a story, you'll need to get the reader hooked right away. Here are a few ways to get you started. Remember to use the 6 W's: who, what, where, when, why, how. On March 6th, journalism teacher Daisy Frankenstock ripped apart the heads of 4 students with her bare hands in the computer lab due to a mediocre story. How about an honest approach? You're reading the story? Oh my gosh, somebody's actually reading the story. Holy frickin' crap. Step 3. Write the rest of it. Remember, only a few kids read the lead-in. Only 2 students in the history of writing have actually finished a story. Knowing this, we don't have to waste any time writing the rest of the story. Simply write anything you want to fill up space. This is a very good example from a world-renowned journalist. Even though the story has no information at all, you can still waste class time by going out to do interviews with your friends, or reminding a teacher to turn in their damn survey by taping an anonymous note to his or her doorknob. Step 4. You're finished! Well, now that the story is completed, you can finally work on the rest of the page. This includes pictures, cutouts, and mods, which people actually care about. Just remember...